Kasey here with Sparkbox, and today I want to show you how I code an SVG pie chart from start to finish. I'm going to be working in CodePen, and I want to keep my SVG completely contained to the HTML, but I do have a little bit of CSS on the page just to make things look nicer. Now, the first thing we need to do is add an SVG element to the page. So we add our open and closing tags, and then we give this SVG a few attributes. First thing, we want to set the height to 20 pixels and the width also to 20 pixels. Next, we need to define the viewable area of the SVG, which is the viewBox attribute. The viewBox takes four numbers. The first two are going to be the X and Y coordinates of the upper left corner, which is 0, 0, and the next two are going to be the X and Y coordinates of the lower right corner, which in our case are going to be 20, 20. Now, our SVG is a little bit on the small side since we set it to 20 pixels by 20 pixels, so we'll use a little bit of CSS just to scale it up to 500 by 500. That'll let us see what we're doing. Since the SVG is a vector element, we can scale it to whatever size we want without losing any image quality. Next, we want to add a circle for the background of our pie chart. The circle element is a self-closing tag, and the first piece of information we need to pass is the radius, which is the R attribute. We want the circle to fill the entire view box, so it's going to need to be half of the width of the SVG. So we'll set it to 10. You'll notice that the circle is off in the upper left corner with most of the circle out of the view box. This is because by default, the center of the circle is positioned at the 0, 0, XY coordinates. In order to move the circle, we can reposition it by setting CX and CY attributes. The CX attribute is going to move the circle along the X axis, and the CY is going to move it along the Y axis. Now that our circle is the correct size and centered, we need to set the fill color to white. For the slice of the pie chart, we're going to be using a second circle element, and we're going to be manipulating the attributes on that element in order to create our little pie wedge. To start, we'll copy and paste the background circle, and then so we can see what we're doing, we'll temporarily update the fill color to bisque. In order to create the pie slice shape, we're going to add a border around the bisque circle. The border on an SVG element is called a stroke, and we add this by giving the stroke attribute a color. Once we do this, we get a default 1 pixel border around the circumference of the circle. Remember that our original SVG is 20 pixels by 20 pixels, and we're scaling the image up, so this border is going to look much larger than 1 pixel wide. If we were to knock the size back a bit, though, it would look more like a 1 pixel border. You'll also notice that some of the stroke is being clipped by the edges of the SVG. When we add a stroke to an SVG element, the width of the stroke is going to be centered along the perimeter of the element. Half of the stroke is going to be on the inside, and the other half is going to be on the outside of the circle. We're going to play around with the stroke to create the pie slice, and in order to keep the stroke from being clipped, we need to resize our bisque circle to be half the size of the background circle. This will allow us to enlarge the size of the stroke while also keeping it all within the view box. When setting a border in CSS, we're able to specify the style of border we want. For instance, we have a dashed border around the perimeter of the SVG itself. We can do something similar with the SVG stroke by setting a stroke-array attribute. If we give the stroke-array a value of 1, we're going to be given a dashed line effect with 1 pixel long dashes, each with a 1 pixel gap in between. We can add a second value to the stroke-array in order to increase the gap between each dash. If we set the second value to 3, we wind up with a 3 pixel gap between each dash. At this point, let's revisit the size of the stroke. Remember, we're given a default 1 pixel wide stroke, but we can update the stroke width and set it to 4. This gives us 2 pixels of border on the inside of the bisque circle and 2 pixels on the outside. And here you can start to see a triangular wedge shape forming. If we increase the stroke width a bit more to be the same size as the radius of the background circle, which is 10, we wind up with a beach ball effect where we have multiple wedges that extend from the center of the background circle all the way to the edges. We only need one of these wedges for our pie slice, so we want to increase the spacing in between each wedge so that we only ever see the one. We can do this by setting the stroke dash array gap to be equal to the circumference of the bisque circle. We'll need to use a little bit of high school math, so if you don't remember, it's 2 times pi times the radius. Or we can use this Google calculator, and we just enter in our radius, which was 5, and we're given the circumference 31.42. When we add this to our SVG, we're left with a single pie wedge. So we can start playing around with the size of the pie slice. We can increase the size of the slice to 10, and we're going to get a much larger wedge. But when we're working with a pie chart, we're usually working with percentages. And I want this 10 to represent 10%. But as you can see, it's much larger than 10% of the pie. We'll need to do a little bit more math. And this time, we're going to do all the math in the SVG using the CSS calc function. To calculate the correct percentage, we'll take our 10% times the circumference, and then we'll divide that number by 100 in order to get our final percentage. Now we have a slice that looks much more like 10%. We can double check this by updating our percentage to 50, and our pie slice takes up exactly half of the chart, and then we can update it again for 35%. Now we have a pie chart, but we need to clean up the code a bit. The first thing we need to adjust is the starting point of the pie slice. Normally, when we see a pie chart, the slices start at the top of the circle, but ours is starting down in the middle. We can fix this by rotating the circle element minus 90 degrees using the transform attribute and the rotate function. The transform attribute is similar to the CSS transform property with some slight syntax differences. Unfortunately, once we rotate our pie slice, it is no longer visible in the view box. This is because circle elements don't rotate on the center of the circle, but instead in the upper left corner. If we adjust the degrees rotated incrementally, you can see how the circle starts to rotate out of view. We can fix this by also passing the translate function to pull the element down minus 20 pixels. Next, we no longer need the bisque fill color for the circle that positions the pie slice. We can either set the fill to white to match the background circle, or we can set it to transparent. And lastly, we no longer need the border around the SVG, so we can remove that style from the CSS. And there you have it, a completed SVG pie chart. It's important to note that using the calc function like we are isn't going to work in IE 11 and older. So if these are browsers that you need to support, you'll have to either do the math yourself or write some JavaScript to do it for you. Be sure to check out the description for a link to the accompanying article with code snippets and links to more resources. Happy coding!